Are you a first-time home buyer in Canada? Well, seeing as you clicked on the video that has a title about first-time home buyers, I'm gonna guess you are. But you're probably thinking right now, what the heck am I doing? Where do I even start? Well, you're in luck. On this episode of Bald Prairie Real Estate, we're gonna go through what I call the three phases of buying a house. In each one of those phases, we'll get three steps. So this is a step-by-step guide on how to buy a house in Canada. By the time you're done watching this video, you're gonna feel like more of an expert than most real estate agents in this country. First time home buyers, this video is for you. Hey guys, welcome back to Bald Prairie Real Estate. Now I might be your favorite bald realtor on YouTube, but my friends like to call me Matthew Pfeiffer when they're being nice to me. I'm a real estate agent in Regina, Saskatchewan. And if you like keeping up to date on the Canadian real estate market, or you just like getting good tips on how to buy and sell real estate or get educated on real estate topics, go ahead, hit that subscribe button so you never miss another one of my videos or my terrible jokes. And this one is a great one, guys. So especially for your first-time home buyers, you're probably thinking now, real estate in Canada has gotten so expensive, you gotta be a cat to buy it because you're gonna need nine lives to pay it off. On this episode of Bald Prairie Real Estate, what I wanna go over is what I like to call the three phases of buying real estate. So we're gonna break down those three phases and the steps within them so you know exactly what you need to do when you're buying a house in Canada. And for first-time home buyers, I think this is really important because you're probably feeling really lost right now, and that's okay. So what I'm gonna do here is we're gonna turn this into just a conversation. It's kind of like if I just met you, we were sitting down over coffee, getting to know each other and figuring out what we need to do to make sure you have the best experience when buying a house. I'm gonna run this video exactly like that. So just a conversation between you and I, and we're gonna help you find the perfect house. Phase one, this is where basically every first-time home buyer is gonna start. When I first meet with buyers, usually this is where they're at. So if right now you're feeling lost, you don't know where to start, who to talk to, where to even look for houses, that's okay, because that's where most people start. And of course, the most important thing you need to do is you gotta have your down payment saved up. In Canada, you have to have at least 5% down in order to buy a house in Canada. But if you have less than 20% down, you've gotta get default mortgage insurance. And I'm gonna cover that in a larger video at some point, but if you wanted a quick crash course, I'm gonna put a video up right here. It's talking about CMHC's changes to default mortgage insurance, but in there, I've got a crash course dedicated entirely to talking about what mortgage default insurance is and why you need it and why it's important. Step two is probably the most important step you're gonna take in buying a house, and that's getting your pre-approval done. And no, this isn't one of those online, quick, hit a couple buttons, boom, instantaneous, approved for a mortgage, you're good to go. No, what you wanna do is you wanna sit down with either your bank's mortgage specialist or mortgage broker and have them do a full pre-approval. They're gonna verify you've got your down payment, they're gonna verify your income and pull your credit score. They're gonna make sure that everything is ready to go financially for you. Because if you don't have that done, sometimes those things like an old cell phone bill you forgot to pay, they come up to haunt you when you've got a deal written on your dream house and all of a sudden you gotta take care of some financial stuff that you didn't expect and now you're in a panic. You don't wanna have that happen. So you wanna get that done ahead of time because then you're also gonna feel very confident anytime you walk in a house knowing, hey, I can afford this house, I'm ready to go. Your last step in phase one is creating a needs list and a wants list. So what you wanna do here is create a list of things that, hey, you have to have this when you're buying a house, and a list of, hey, this would be really great if I could have this. Sometimes though, it's easier to almost kind of work this question backwards. Maybe start with, hey, these are deal breakers for me. I can't have this in a house. I'm not gonna buy it. So things that I would consider as must-haves are, you know, location and bedrooms, maybe a garage is a must-have, you have to have that. And then there's some things like wants. I want an updated kitchen. I want a certain type of flooring, things like that. So start with that. It's not only gonna help you when you're going through homes because you're gonna be able to have essentially a checklist and go, yep, this meets that. But it also really helps us, your real estate agents. I wish I could read your mind because if I could, I promise you, I would find the perfect house right away for you. But we don't have that ability yet. Maybe we'll get it in the future. So make that list of wants and needs, write it down, and it'll help us find you that perfect house. Speaking of wants and needs, if you're buying a house right now, put in the comments below, what's something that you absolutely have to have in a house that you wouldn't buy a house unless it has it? I'm curious to know, what do you guys find important? Okay, so did I bore you to death with all those financial details and prep work that doesn't seem like it's important to buying a house at all? Well, you probably already clicked off anyway, so hey, thanks for sticking around so far, because guess what? Now you're in the fun phase. Phase two, shopping for a house. And this is something that I really enjoy doing. I like going out and showing people houses, even though it takes a lot of time sometimes, that's okay. I love having the conversations with my clients, getting to know them better, building that relationship, and finding that right house for them, because you know what? Almost always, you know right away when it's the right one as soon as they walk in the door. Okay, enough of me rambling on about how much I like showing houses. You came here to learn, so let's talk about first step in phase two. So step one is when you're actually going out and physically looking at houses. This is the fun part. You're gonna go through them, and you should have that checklist I talked about, that wants and needs list, and go through and start marking off. Does this house fit that criteria you've outlined that you've said is important to you? And sometimes it can be tough to look past, hey, this house has got a fantastic kitchen. It's beautiful. Make sure it fits that list, because that's important. But I'll let you in on a little secret. You'll walk into a house, might be the first house, might be the 50th, but you're gonna walk in and go, wow, this is perfect. Because the mentality you want when you're looking through houses is, do you see yourself living there? And if the answer to that question is no, quit the showing right then, go on to the next house. There's no point even wasting time, continue to look through it. If you're not feeling like that's the right house for you, it's not the right one. But what you will do is you'll walk into one house at some point, you go, this is absolutely perfect. And that's probably one you're gonna end up buying. It's one you should think about for sure. As you're going through showings, and I would only book maybe 3 to 5 at a time, going through too many more than that, they become a blur and it's tough to remember them all. But it's also nice to go through a few back to back, because you can compare and contrast them. And it'll give you a good idea of what's gonna be available in your price point or in the neighborhoods you're looking for. It'll really help having that comparison. Now you've found the absolute perfect house, you gotta write an offer on it. So let's go through that. Now I'm gonna talk about conditional offers here. I know in some of those really hot real estate markets in Canada, you guys are writing unconditional offers, and that's a whole different beast when you get into those. But I'm gonna talk about conditional offers. This is what you're gonna find in a balanced market or a buyer's market. And even in those hot real estate markets, I think this is important to have conditions to an offer. So things like your financing and your home inspection. Those are important things, and I highly recommend doing them in every single offer that you do. Get to know that house inside and out through things like a home inspection. And I'm gonna go through those a little bit later here, because guess what? That's the last step. There's three big battlegrounds when you're writing an offer. First one is pretty easy, price point. The second one is gonna be the possession date. And the third one is gonna be the inclusion. So let's start off with price point. As you're going through houses, you're gonna start to get a feel for what pricing is like in your neighborhood or the type of house you're looking for. But your real estate agent's gonna be able to go through and show you all the comparables in the neighborhood that have sold recently, higher and lower. Don't be afraid to walk away from a deal if it's not right, especially on something like price. Make sure you're comfortable with that. An agent's gonna be able to guide you through that and where pricing needs to be. Possession date is another important one. Sometimes sellers have specific possession days they wanna hit because maybe they have already bought a house and they're trying to overlap those. And maybe you've got a rental place that you're trying to get out of and you wanna make sure that possession date lines up so you're not double paying. So possession date is another big battleground. And the third one is inclusions. In a house, think of it this way. Anything that's screwed down to the wall, that's considered included. If it isn't screwed down to the wall or floor, you have to ask for it in the offer. So something like appliances, a fridge, it's not screwed in anywhere typically. That's why you've got to ask for things like that in your inclusions. Rank those as to what's most important to you, whether it's price point, possession, or inclusions, and try to go after that when you're writing your offer of that order of importance. So if price point is the most important thing to you, go and try to get the price points you want. You might have to give a little bit on possession day and inclusions. So that's kind of the quick overview of writing a conditional offer. The last step in phase two is your inspections. And you should get that house inspected top to bottom. Again, I know in some of these hot real estate markets, home inspections are a detriment to getting your offer accepted, but I highly recommend you do inspections. So home inspection is gonna do a good job of covering kind of the house top to bottom with a general overview. But you should make sure that you get any specific questions that are maybe specific to your area answered. My area in Regina, we have bad basements because we've got very expansive soil. I'm gonna put up a few photos here somewhere. You guys are not from Regina are gonna be horrified to look at these photos and what basements look like in Regina. So Foundation inspections are really important to Regina, but 2 hours away in Saskatoon, you wouldn't worry about them because it's pretty much a non-issue. So go through, get your inspections done. That wraps up phase two. That's the fun phase. Phase three is kind of the boring phase of all the phases, but it's the details phase. And this is really important, okay? So the first part of phase three is removing conditions. So you put all those conditions on your offer. You want to make sure that those conditions are all satisfied and you have no more questions with the house. So you've got your financing approved the way you want it. You've got all your inspections done. You've got any questions asked there. If you remove conditions and you change your mind, that deposit that came with that offer, well, now that's in jeopardy. The seller may be able to claim that. So once you've removed conditions, there's now money in the game here that you might lose. So make sure you're absolutely 100% satisfied before remove conditions. Again, it's the details. Step number two in phase three is gonna be making sure you've got your investment, because that's what it is. When you're buying a house, it is an investment. You've got it insured. Now people think, okay, home insurance, I'm done. That's not it. Although home insurance is very important, you have to get that done before you can even take possession. But there's also two components in here that are really important. And that's gonna be obviously life insurance, but also even more important is gonna be disability or loss of work insurance. These things are really important. Obviously, if you were to pass away, you would want a policy in place to pay that investment out so that your family or whoever you're leaving that house to doesn't have a debt. But also loss of work. This is really important nowadays as people have been out of work, having an insurance policy. Now, COVID-19 probably isn't covered under most people's insurance policies, but if you were to get injured in a car accident, something like that, and you're not able to work, having insurance policy in place to pay for that home is really important. The last thing you want is to be out of work and lose your house because you're out of work. I've seen it happen, guys. I've had clients who have lost their home because of a disability and they didn't have any insurance in place. So you don't want to be in that situation where you can't pay for your home because you've lost your job. You finally made it. You're at possession day, the last step in buying a house. And this is a fun day for me. I really enjoy giving people those keys and saying, open the door for the first time for your new house. But there's a couple of things you gotta think about. First off, usually when you write those offers, you're gonna put in there a date and a time for possession. So 10 a.m. on a Friday. Don't book your moving trucks for 10 a.m. on that Friday. I promise you, Murphy's Law, because you booked them at 10 a.m., something's gonna happen. There's gonna be a small hiccup and a delay and you can't take possession until 12 or something like that. So don't book the moving trucks for 10 a.m. Assume things are gonna happen, but be prepared if they don't quite happen on time. The delays can be frustrating. I know, I see it all the time. And then when you get there, you wanna do a quick walk through the house. Make sure that all the house possessions you asked for, the inclusions, you know, with the appliances, things like that, make sure they're all there. I've been through it before where you go to a house and you'd ask for the appliances to be included, and the seller took them. It happens. Usually it's by accident. They forget that something was supposed to be included and they took it with them. So go through that, make sure that the whole house is as expected and make sure it's in the condition that you expected, that it's been cleaned up and everything like that. Again, it happens. Sometimes houses aren't really in the condition you expect them to be. So do a walkthrough as you first take possession of the house. Make sure everything is as expected. There you have it. Three easy steps, easy peasy. You can get a house bought. Do you feel like an expert yet? You probably got a few more questions. Go ahead, put them in the comments below. Maybe there's something I glossed over you want more information on. So put it in the comments below, I'll get it answered for you. And if you're a first time home buyer, you probably do have some questions. That's okay. I got a whole series of videos dedicated to you, the first time home buyer. I'll put it right here. So check that out. It's probably gonna answer a bunch of your questions. And if one of those questions is, where the heck is the real estate market going? What's happening? Is the market gonna crash? Or is it going through the roof? Are we in a really hot seller's market? Right here. That's where the Canadian real estate market's at. You can check that video out. Thanks for watching, guys. And if you like this video, give me the thumbs up. Even better, hit the subscribe button. I really appreciate all your support.